architect. I've been practicing since MultiCAD was registered in 1994. MultiCAD Consulting is a firm of architects, planners, and engineers. And I'm also the president of the Ghana Institute of Architects. I've been practicing in this country for almost 30 years. And I believe I know the country fairly well and the practice. There's a lot of work in retail, commercial, and offices. We do very little residences. Our strengths are more in retail and in offices. We've done a lot of industrial work as well, some very unique industrial projects. But this is our core, this is what we do. Recently we've done a very good city design, an urban design for a town, a township, which is a suburb of Accra called Apollonia, which is a mixed-use city with residential, commercial, public spaces, and so on. So that's basically what architects is supposed to bring together all architects in order to ensure standards and ethics, to ensure that a constitution is followed, and to make sure that the knowledge of the profession increases with time. To practice in Ghana, you must be a member of the Ghana Institute of Architects. You cannot call yourself an architect without being a member of the Ghana Institute of Architects.
Okay.
After that, then you can be given a certificate by the Registration Council. So that's what the Ghana Institute of Architects. Architect first must follow an approved course of study. For instance, if you studied in Politecnico di Milano or anywhere,
okay.
You must confirm with the Registration Council and the Ghana Institute of Architects whether the course of study is acceptable. That's one. If it is acceptable, then for those who studied in Ghana, what you do is you apply to be a probationer, which means you then follow an internship. You have to be under a firm or a practice or an individual who will take you through the professional training period. Typically, you will have a minimum of 2 years. It's preferred to have 3 years of tutelage in the professional practice. So, and you must have a record of all the projects, and it must be signed off. And this is submitted to the Ghana Institute of Architects and the Architects Registration Council. It's difficult to talk about Ghanaian architecture because we work in an environment where international influences have dissolved the impact of culture on our work. There are a few individuals or architects who try to sustain what can be called Ghanaian architecture. They are very few. And these try to input elements of form, planimetric form, and motif. They also try to embody material, organic material, a more earthy material base for the fabric of the building.
Yeah.
And then to input some plan forms that reflect the culture and the communal living of Ghanaians. But this is giving way to a more international flavor in terms of what we do, because urbanization sometimes makes these concepts difficult to fulfill.
Yeah.
So that's, but there is an aesthetic influence, you know, which is more to do with the visual, and that you can find in a minority of architects. And this aesthetic is derived from motifs such as the sculpture of the country, the symbolism, which comes from symbols that have been developed over time in Akan culture and so on. These are the elements that can define Ghanaian architecture. Work hard at bringing the thinking of architects back. And it's not going to be easy to get them to produce an identity, because the external forces are so strong.